Yeah. and the joy of the Son given to us be with you all. Light looked down and saw darkness. I will go there, said Light. Peace looked down and saw war. I will go there, said Peace. Love looked down and saw hatred. I will go there, said Love. So the Lord of Light, the Prince of Peace, and the King of Love came down and crept in beside us. Let us pray. Almighty God, you made this holy night shine with the brightness of the true light. Grant that here on earth we may walk in the light of Jesus' presence, and in the last day wake to the brightness of his glory. Through your only Son, Jesus Christ our Lord, who lives and reigns with you in the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen.
Away in a manger, no crib for his bed, the little Lord Jesus laid down his sweet head. The stars in the sky looked down where he lay, the little Lord Jesus asleep on the
as with joy at the harvest, as people exult when dividing plunder. For the yoke of their burden and the bar across their shoulders, the rod of their oppressor, you have broken as on the day of Midian. For all the boots of the tramping warriors and all the garments rolled in blood shall be burned as fuel for the fire. For a child has been born for us, a son given to us. Authority rests upon his shoulders, and he is named Wonderful Counselor, Mighty God, Everlasting Father, Prince of Peace. His authority shall grow continually, and there shall be endless peace for the throne of David and his kingdom. He will establish and uphold it with justice and with righteousness from this time onward and forevermore. The zeal of the Lord of hosts will do this. This is the word of the Lord. Thanks be to God.
Come down to the manger, see the little stranger, wrapped in swaddling, lo, the Prince of Peace. The wheels start turning, torches start burning, and behold, wise men journey from the How the little baby boy bring the people so much joy. Son of a carpenter, Mary carried the light. This must be Christmas, must be tonight. A shepherd on the hillside, where over my flock I bide. Cold winter night, a band of angels sing. In a dream I heard a voice say, fear not, come rejoice. It's the end of the beginning, praise the newborn King. How the little baby boy bring the people so much joy. Son of a carpenter, Mary carried the light. This must be Christmas, must be tonight. I saw it with my own eye, written up in the sky. Why a simple herdsman such as I? And then it came to pass, he was born at last. Right below the star that shines on high. How the little baby boy bring the people so much joy. Son of a carpenter, Mary carried the light. This must be Christmas, must be tonight. Come down to the manger, see the little stranger, wrapped in swaddling, lo, the Prince of Peace. Son of a carpenter, Mary carried the light. This must be Christmas, must be tonight. Be tonight. Be tonight. Be tonight. Be tonight. Be
tonight. I want to tell you the story of Christmas as found in the Gospel of Luke, the 2nd chapter. A decree went out from Emperor Caesar Augustus that all the world should be registered. Now this was the first census and was taken while Quirinius was governor of Syria. All went to their own hometown to be registered. Joseph also went from the town of Nazareth in Galilee to Judea, to the city of David, which is called Bethlehem, because he was of the house and family of David. He went to be registered with Mary, to whom he was engaged and who was expecting a child. And while they were there, the time came for Mary to deliver her child, and she gave birth to her firstborn son, and she wrapped him in swaddling clothes, and she laid him in a manger, because there was no room for them in the inn. Meanwhile, out in the fields, there were shepherds watching over their flock by night, and an angel of the Lord appeared to them, and the glory of the Lord shone around them, and they were terrified. But the angel said to them, "Do not be afraid. I bring you good news of greatest joy. Unto you is born this day in the city of David a Savior, who is Christ the Lord. And this will be a sign for you. You will find a child wrapped in swaddling clothes and lying in a manger." And suddenly there was with that angel a multitude of heavenly hosts, glorifying and praising God and saying, "Glory to God in the highest, and peace to God's people on earth." Now when the angels had finished and gone back up into heaven, the shepherds said to one another, "Let us go over to Bethlehem and see this thing which has happened, which the Lord has made known to us." And so they went with haste, and they found Mary and Joseph and the child wrapped in swaddling clothes and lying in a manger. And when they saw this, they told everyone the things that had been said to them about this child. And all who heard it were astonished. But Mary treasured all these things, pondering them in her heart. Then the shepherds went back home to their fields, glorifying and praising God for all they had heard and seen, just as it had been told to them. Here ends the story of Christmas.
Thank you.
So I talked to my mom the other day. She was getting ready for Christmas. She told me, well, she's got only a small tree this year in the corner, and she's got a few gifts already awaiting my arrival. And then she said, well, she got the box of decorations in from the shelves in the garage, and she began to unpack them, including her manger scenes. And she suddenly cried out, but I pulled out that manger scene, the one we got on our trip to Bermuda years ago, and Joseph is missing. I pulled him out of the box, he wasn't there. I went through all of the papers and the tissue paper in the box and hoping he would just drop out from somewhere. But Joseph was nowhere to be found. He's missing. I could tell my mom was missing some favorite piece of this special manger scene. And then I found myself chuckling a little bit. I began musing about past years when there had been May Days at the manger, when something just didn't seem to go right or somebody was missing. One of my favorites was the time when baby Jesus came unglued from his cradle. Imagine that, baby Jesus unglued. That just sounds like it should be a story on the internet. And then there was the family that told me about their manger scene, and one of the camels had a broken leg, and so he was always hobbling through the straw. And then there was the shepherd who popped out, but the sheep, not all of them were there. There was one missing somewhere. And one year, one family had Mary, and she sustained a broken arm with a child that had been just a little too rough. And there's always the angel that's, well, their halo's a little bit crooked. And one of my favorites also, there was the wise men, one of whom kept dropping his gift. I kind of like it, I realized, when the characters at the manger don't seem to have it all together. When I think of manger scenes, like the one I have behind me up here, they look so pristine. They're all in their places. Everybody holds their pose so gently. The animals are on their best behavior. But it's kind of fun. It seems more natural and more realistic to think of them as, well, coming with their aches and pains and their brokenness and their imperfections, because they're all gathering to see this child wrapped in swaddling clothes and lying in a manger. It makes them easier to relate to in their less than perfect states. There can be so much pressure to have just the perfect Christmas. By the time you're watching this, you probably know what I'm talking about. Oh, something didn't go right, the cookies got burned, or the guests were late, or the package didn't arrive on time, the things that cause our blood pressure to go through the roof and we stress and worry about. Somehow in the pristine manger scenes, we think that all is calm and peaceful, and that this night somehow seems holier than the rest of the nights throughout the year. Oh, and then the carols are sung in perfect harmony, and all the Christmas lights are working and blinking in orchestrated fashion. And the kids, of course, are minding their best manners, even the pets. And there are smiles on everyone's faces, and everyone just can get along for one night of the year. Then I was thinking, a lot of that isn't really how Christmas happens. Is that all that matters each Christmas? That everything be in the right place and we can have a perfect night? Is that what makes this night so holy? Or might it be that the holiness of this night is found in the human and humble moments when things are not going as planned or expected? I imagine that first holy night was not perfect, despite the Christmas cards greetings that make it look like it was so. We had that young couple, Mary and Joseph, out in a stable of all places because, well, it was full. The inn was full. There's a Christmas card out for sale. You might have seen it. And in that one, Mary and Joseph are in the stable, and the little bubbles on the card tell us what they're thinking in their minds, and they're having an argument because Joseph is apologizing for the umpteenth time for forgetting to make the reservation. So when they got there, there was no room at the inn, and Mary is a little peeved with him, as you can imagine. So here she is giving birth in a stable. Now, the Bible doesn't say that's how it happened, but we can use our imagination to think there might have been some undertones to that holy night. We do know that the whole community was under taxation, and they were living in poverty, and there was oppression living under the harsh rule of the Roman emperor. So things were not all fine and dandy in Bethlehem. And then I think of the shepherds out in the fields watching over their flocks by night. Such a pastoral scene. Except those shepherds were constantly on their guard, watching out for hungry predators who would really like to have a lamb supper in the near future. They lie in wait. And we know the shepherds are out there waiting and standing their guard, protecting their sheep with all their might. And all of a sudden, up in the heavens, an angel interrupts their calm and peaceful meditations. And the shepherds, we're told, are terrified. The King James Version said, and they were sore afraid. That's the old way of saying scared out of their wits, we might say. And in the thick of it all, we have a new birth. A crying baby, and a legion of angels bringing good news. Glory to God in the highest, and peace to God's people on earth. At first, the news the shepherds receive is just hard to imagine and comprehend, let alone accept as true. So the shepherds decide they better go check this out. Let us go over to Bethlehem and see this thing which has happened, that the Lord has made known to us. And so Luke tells us they went with haste. They hurried. They made their way through the dark of night. I'm not sure what they did with their flocks, unless they corralled them all and woke them up and took them in the dark of night. And there, when they arrive in Bethlehem, they see that sign for themselves. A child wrapped in swaddling clothes and lying in a manger. It is a precious sight to behold. In fact, it's that moment when the shepherds arrive in Bethlehem and see Mary and Joseph and the child that takes my breath away every year as I think about this story. When they see that child for themselves with their very own eyes, and they behold him, the long-awaited Messiah. So they tell everyone what the angel had said to them out there in the fields. And all who heard it, Luke says, were astonished, amazed, and maybe a bit perplexed and still wondering. And isn't that what Christmas is really all about? Seeing the Christ child with our very own eyes and in our very own midst. Awakening to the presence of Jesus in our struggles and in our confusion, in the darkest moments of the night. This, for me, is where Christmas is found. He comes in the middle of the tensions between the family members, even if we are gathered around the same table. He comes in the midst of sadness and sufferings that stem from our disappointments and our griefs and our losses. He comes, this child does, in the midst of pain and suffering and injustices, and even in a pandemic with its devastation and deaths, this holy child comes to us today. This year, I think we are more like those imperfect characters of the Nativity than the perfect ones. You know, the ones that you're not allowed to touch for fear of breaking them. This year, I envision all of us gathered around that child in that manger, gathered ourselves. We come hobbling with broken legs or ankles. We come unglued as we may be, like the baby Jesus. Still, we come, even with the shepherds missing their flocks and away from their families. And we come like the angels with crooked or tarnished or missing halos. And we come like the wise men, bumbling our gifts. This holy night is a night where imperfect and broken and bruised people gather around a manger all around the world to glimpse this child in our midst and to behold his glory. No matter how difficult the present moment or circumstances may be, we look for signs of his presence on this very night and ponder these things in our heart. And when this night is over and we wake up to a new day, let us take care that we do not pack them all up and put them away on a shelf, but that we remember these holy people, broken and less than perfect as they are. And may we join them in our search for this child who is promised, so that we may behold him every single day throughout the year. Amen.
Thank you.
rejoicing in God's gift of gentle grace. Let us pray for the church, the world, and all on whom the light of Christ shines. God, you are the wonderful counselor. You increase our joy as the church gathers on this holy night to sing of your presence among us. May the story of salvation live in the hearts of all who sing of your wonders. You are the mighty God. You broke the yoke of sin's burden through the birth of your Son. Comfort those whose burdens distract them from the deeper peace of this holy night, and grant us a peaceful mind. You are the everlasting Father. Uphold all who are in sorrow or in need of your divine goodness and mercy. We remember with thanksgiving all who have died and who now rest in your peaceful light. You are the Prince of Peace. May your reign be known in all places of violence and unrest, and grant resolution to conflicts throughout this world. Hear our prayers, gracious God, and bathe us always in the light of your word made flesh, Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen. Let us now join together in joy and confidence in praying the Lord's Prayer. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. May the peace of the Christ child be with you always. filled with the wonder of Mary, the obedience of Joseph, the joy of the angels, the eagerness of the shepherds, and the determination of the wise men, and the peace of Christ. May Almighty God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit bless you now and forever. Amen.
Tell it on the mountain that Jesus Christ is.